Mr. President, Secretary-General, Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen.
The one country in the world today where I'm sad to say the state sponsors Islamophobia, and that is India. The reason behind this is the RSS ideology that unfortunately rules India today. This extremist ideology was founded in the 1920s. The RSS founding fathers were inspired by the Nazis, and they adopted their concepts of racial purity and supremacy. While the Nazis' hate was directed at the Jews, the RSS directs it towards the Muslims and, to a lesser extent, the Christians. They believe that India is exclusively for Hindus and others are not equal citizens. The secularism of Gandhi and Nehru has been replaced by the dream of creating a Hindu Rashtra, by subjugating, even cleansing India's 200 million Muslims and other minorities. In 1992, the RSS destroyed the Babri Masjid. In 2002, some 2,000 Muslims were slaughtered in Gujarat, and this was under the watch of Chief Minister Modi. In 2007, over 50 Muslims were burnt alive by RSS arsonists aboard the Samjhota Express train. In Assam, around 2 million Muslims faced the prospects of being arbitrarily stripped of their nationality through the adoption of discriminatory laws. There are reports of large concentration camps being filled by Muslim Indian citizens. Muslims were falsely blamed, vilified, and victimized for spreading the coronavirus. They were denied medical attention on many occasions. Their businesses were boycotted. Cow vigilantes attack and kill Muslims with impunity. Last February, Muslims faced targeted killings with police complicity in New Delhi. Mass registrations in the past have often been a precursor to genocide. For example, the Nuremberg Laws in Germany in 1935, and then in 1982 in Myanmar. The Hindutva ideology is said to marginalize almost 300 million human beings, Muslims, Christians, and Sikhs. This is unprecedented in history, and this does not augur well for the future of India, as we all know that marginalization of human beings leads to their radicalization.